Hello and welcome to this tutorial on shooting 3D game objects to mouse click position in game space using linear motion. Here, as you can see, the game object moves towards the mouse click in world space and stops when it first collides with the targets. If the target position is not on targets but somewhere else, after collision it falls to the ground. While falling, if it collides with the targets, it again sticks to them. Here we are shooting the object with no gravity, so that it will not be affected by the gravitational force. If it was affected, our solution would work partially and the object would present a parabolic motion. Before going into details for this project, I want to show you possible feature upgrades for this series. If you are not curious, you can continue with the next timestamp, otherwise I will be happy to hear your thoughts in the comments. The thing is, I have been using target shooting logic with the projectile motion for some time, and later on I use that for trajectory prediction on drag and shoot series. Even though I want to create videos on them, currently I'm not sure if I can explain the physics part well. So I will start with this shooting series and build upon that. Plus, at one point there will be a target shooting scoring video. The score player gets will be affected by the position of the collision. The closer the object is to the center of the target, the higher the score it will get. If this kind of physics-based, logic-based target shooting tutorials interests you, please let me know in the comments. I really appreciate it. Thanks. Now continuing on. First of all the models used in this tutorial from KKit minigame variety pack. I really love these models, and if you would like to use them in your projects, you can get them from its each page, which is linked in the description. Let's see the editor side first. Be careful here because it will help you if you ever want to recreate this tutorial. Here in the environment, I have some plants, wall, ground, and a small pipe object. Other than the plants, all have colliders. Targets have mesh colliders and stick tags. This will be important for spam to stick them. Show cursor is here to allow me to show you mouse clicks. How it works is explained in a previous video linked in the description. Last but not least, Spawn Manager. Currently holds Spawn Shooter and Spawner Behaviors. Those with Spawn Behavior are the focus of this tutorial. Let's start with Spawner. It takes two information from the editor. Reference to Spawn Behavior of the object that we will be spawning, Spawn Prefab, and the duration to wait between a spawn shot and a new spawn, spawn duration in seconds. That means after a spawn is shot, the spawner waits 2 seconds to spawn a new spawn object. Spawn is spawned in the position of the spawn manager. Here in the spawn manager, we have a sphere trigger collider. We use its trigger exit event to detect the spawn, leaving the spawner, and call for a new spawn. Spawn shooter is the behavior that we use to select a shooting strategy and prepare the values for the spawn to move according to this strategy. In this case, we move the spawn with linear motion and the spawn shooter calculates the velocity of our spawn, then conveys this information to it. Next time, the information will be a force vector, for example. Here, flight duration in seconds represents time spent before reaching the target. Lower the value, faster the spawn reaches the target. Lastly, spawn script in the editor. It is on the objects that we are shooting. For collisions and movement to work, the object should have a rigid body component. In this implementation, we assume no gravity and drag forces, so use of gravity should be unchecked and drag should be zero. We won't be rotating it yet, so no need to set angular drag to zero. I am also interested in rotating it for a future video. Let me know if you're interested too. Okay, here we have stick tag, that is the tag of the game objects that spawn will stick. If you want the object to stick to objects with different tags, I can suggest transforming this into a list. I believe this was it from the editor. Now let me walk you through the code starting from spawner. Spawner has three variables. Spawner prefab refers to spawn behavior of the spawn object. We will be using the reference as well as the game object property from this variable. Spawn duration in seconds. Duration between a spawn, leaving the spawner's collider, and a new spawn instantiated. Lastly, spawn shooter. Reference to spawn shooter of game object that also owns spawner. At the start, we fill the spawn shooter using get component spawn shooter. Then we call for the first spawn using new spawn function. This function instantiates the spawn prefabs game object to the position and rotation of the spawner and delivers the reference of spawn behavior of this spawn object to SpawnShooter by calling SpawnShooter.changeCurrentSpawn with information of spawn behavior of newly instantiated spawn object. On trigger exit, we look for if the spawn object inside the spawner's collider left it. We know if the object left the spawner has spawn behavior by other.getComponentSpawn. If the object is the spawn behavior using invoke function, we call this spawn function after spawn duration in seconds. To sum it all up, spawner spawns the spawn and informs SpawnShooter when it does so. Let's continue with SpawnShooter. In this behavior, we choose how to shoot the spawn. For example, this time we use linear motion, but next time we may use trajectory motion. We have four variables here: flight duration in seconds, time spent in the air before the object collides with the target position if the object does not collide with some middle obstacle. This helps us to calculate the velocity. Current spawn is the reference to the currently available spawn. Main camera is the reference of the main camera. We use it to transform the mouse position to workspace position. Lastly, isShot is our control boolean so that when we signal the spawn to move before the new spawn reference arrives, we won't change it from its course. At the start, we fill main camera reference from camera.main. ChangeCurrentSpawn is the function SpawnShooter gets informed that there is a new spawn by the spawner behavior. CurrentSpawn references the new spawn and the object was not shot yet, so isShot is set to false. In update, we look for left mouse button clicks with input.getMouseButton down 0. Even the mouse clicked, if the spawn already shot, we don't have to process anything, so by calling return, we omit other actions. But if the object was not shot, we need to shut it and continue. First, we define our rayCasted variable, then the ray, by using main camera screen point ray with the value of mouse position. This will be the ray that starts from the camera and goes through the workspace. When we cast this ray, if it hits any colliders, we use the hit position as our target position and call shoot with velocity function with this information. Since this video is about linear motion with no restrictions like gravity, we can directly use the equation of velocity equals distance divided by time. Flight time is something we decided from the editor, a constant value, so we need to calculate the distance. Distance is calculated for each axis by subtracting the starting position of the spawn object from the target position. Then we give the information of this velocity to the spawn object we want to shoot using move with velocity function. After we signal the spawn to move, that means it was shot, so isShot set to true. Before continuing on with spawn, I have prepared a small explanation scene for velocity calculation. Let me show you. Here are our spawn and the spawn on target position. This is the target position that the mouse is clicked on. Cylinders are the distance for each axis the object should go through. When they are combined, we get the direct path that represents its distance to target position. By dividing those distances by flight duration, we find velocity vectors for each axis and use them to set the velocity value of the rigid body. Now we went through the spawner and spawn shooter. Going back to spawn script, this is the object that moves with the information coming from the shooter and spawned by the spawner. It has an editor editable string variable called stick tag. We use this tag to stick to objects with this tag. It caches its rigidbody in _rigidbody at the start and uses it to move and on collision logic. In this case, object moves with constant velocity with the information given from the shooter by setting rigidbody's velocity to the new velocity value. And when the object collides with a collider, we check if the other object has a stick tag. If it has it, we stop our game object by setting its rigidbody to kinematic. Otherwise, our object should not stick, but should be affected by the gravity and fall down. That's why we set use gravity to true. These were the scripts we used to create the initial demo. Again, this series uses a mouse for input, but you can transform it to touch click, via controller interaction or some other logic you control with your input system. So keep that in mind. With this, we are at the end of this tutorial. If there was a point not clear, please let me know in the comments. If you like this video and want to see more of these, give this one a like and subscribe for the future ones. As I said in the start, if you're interested in any kind of trajectory motion and related things, I am motivated to create videos on them. With that, I hope to see you in the next explorations, and bye bye!